सबका विश्वास, सबका विकास, सब साथ में. सो इफ यू हैव द पीपल सब साथ में, थिंग्स आर ईजियर. एंड सबका विश्वास मीन्स एवरी वन हैज टू हैव कॉन्फिडेंस इन यू, एंड देन ओनली डेवलपमेंट इज पॉसिबल. आई थिंक द प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज सेड थिंग्स प्रॉपरली, बट दिस पर्टिकुलर इश्यू इज क्रिएटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ डिविजन अमंग द पीपल.
And don't make a distinction on the basis of religion as such.
Okay, so I'm very happy, and we would like to give our reactions regarding the Citizens Amendment Act that government is proposing, or rather has proposed to all of us. I will read out what we have in mind, what is our reaction, and perhaps then you can also share with us. We would like to hand this over to the Honorable Governor today, and through him communicate to the central government, the President, the Prime Minister, and the others in authority as to what is our reaction. Memorandum submitted to the President of TUI, submitted to the President of India, the Prime Minister of India, the Governor of Karnataka, by Most Reverend Peter Machado, Metropolitan Archbishop of Bangalore and President of the All Karnataka United Christian Forum for Human Rights on 9th January 2020. The response of all the Christians of Karnataka to the Citizenship Amendment Bill. The Parliament has passed the Citizenship Amendment Bill, Amendment Act on 12th December 2019 that proposes to accord citizenship to illegal Hindu, Sikh, Buddhist, Jain, Parsis and Christian migrants from Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan. It naturally implies that the migrants who identify themselves with any group or community other than those mentioned above from these countries won't be eligible for citizenship. The bill also relaxes the provisions of the citizenship by naturalization. The proposed law reduces duration of residency from the existing 11 years to just 5 years for people belong to the same 6 religions and 3 countries. The Citizenship Amendment Bill has caused misunderstanding among the people and led lots of violence and uproar in Assam, and now slowly spreading to other parts of the country as well. While appealing to the citizens to maintain peace and harmony, we stress this very much, that peace and harmony is very important for our country, and in spite of any misunderstanding or any problem, there is no room for violence. And we as Christians, we propagate peace in the country, and we will also work very hard towards attaining this peace in our country. And that should not recourse to violent methods to fight for their cause. We appeal to the central government to grant citizenship to the migrants, not on the basis of their religions, but on the merit of each individual case. Mm-hmm. We wish to reiterate the statement by His Eminence Oswald Cardinal Gracious, Metropolitan Archbishop of Bombay and President of CBCI. He is the President for the whole India Christians, Catholics and Christians together. And he has made a statement which we take it as our statement on the part of all the Christians of India as one opinion of ours. Regarding the Citizenship Amendment Act, that there is a danger that there could be polarization of our peoples along the religious lines, which is very harmful for the country. Religion should never be the criterion for citizenship of a country. Nor is violence a solution when there is a difference of opinion. It is necessary that the government dialogues with those opposing the act, come to an agreement about the way forward with justice, equity and fairness. There is no harm in backtracking, changing course if this is necessary for the good of the country and the people. By doing so, it can mete out justice to all the migrants and thus promote equality among them. More so, it can also convince the citizens of the country that it upholds the sacredness of the Constitution and respects the rights of all the linguistic and religious minorities without any discrimination. Through this memorandum, We wish to stress the point that the Christian community will continue to work for the betterment of all the citizens without any discrimination and will continue to build the nation based on equality, justice and fairness. And we also express our solidarity with those who have been discriminated on the basis of religion and assure them of our support and fellowship, that justice may be granted to them and that all of us may live as one family, as brothers and sisters in this our motherland. Most Reverend Peter Machado, Metropolitan Archbishop of Bangalore and President of All Christian, All Karnataka, United Christian Forum for Human Rights. Basically, three points we stress. Number one is there should be peace in the country. There is no place for violence. There is no place for any sort of this thing that makes harm to public property and also among the people. And secondly, we say that the Constitution is the almost the highest book for us, and let us keep up the tenets of the Constitution in every matter. Number three is, as regards, specifically as regards this bill, we say that let not religion be the criterion for deciding citizenship. If it is worthy, if it is proper, let all the people get it, but not on the basis of religion. And India is a country which has got 5,000 or plus more years of civilization, of being together and toleration, the mercy and compassion, especially for the minorities and those who are suffering. May this tradition continue among us. Let us not distinguish ourselves. You know that our country is considered one of the greatest democracies and the greatest country of tradition, which other people are trying to copy from us. And so this, let this religion matter not become an issue for us. This is our request and pray to the government.
As it stands,
it does not look, I mean, it looks good, but there are implications in that for which people, as you know, will have to suffer. For example, the population register that has to be made cannot be made on just oral assertions. It has to be on the documents. And India is a country, is what we call, we have more oral tradition. We believe each other, we trust each other, and life goes along. But if you start on the document side, we know there's going to be a big problem for the people, especially for the poor people who have no records, no registers, who will find it difficult. And especially there are certain sections among us will be much more difficult. For example, the women. The women. Women, as we know, go from place to place. They are married in one place, they stay in another place, and no one carries their documents as such. So there are implications of that sort, perhaps because of which the government also has to be sensitive to these special considerations of our Indian population.
Sir, Christians are one of the beneficiaries, if you go by the CEA. So what fears you the most?
We are not opposing the CAA in theory, but in practical consideration of it, to make religion a factor, to say that is only our issue. Don't make religion an issue. That's
how, all. How can you read the statement of Prime Minister? She says that the CAA is nothing to do with the Indian citizen. Their act is completely misunderstood and hence the protests are happening across the nation.
I am not very sure, because there is a big majority of the people, a big section of the people. You think everyone has misunderstood? There are intelligentsia among us, there are learned people among us who are expressing their opinions. Are they so ignorant? Perhaps we'll have to sort of, I think the humility of our statesman is to accept our Prime Minister Modi, for whom we have highest respect. He has said, Sabka Viswas, Sabka Vikas, Sab Saath Mein. So if you have the people Sab Saath Mein, things are easier. And Sabka Viswas means everyone has to have confidence in you, and then only development is possible. I think the Prime Minister has said things properly, but this particular issue is creating a lot of division among the people.
Do you think that the Christian community has been a little slow in reacting to this? Because most of the bishops have not spoken out, and I think in Kerala, where the Christian community is very sensitive, I think only Bishop Susapakyam has spoken out against this. Nobody else has spoken out.
I'm not very sure. Because one thing is, we don't want to contribute to the general confusion once again by going in the streets, by joining the things and all. Because we know the problem of the police, of the government, etc. In these matters, we are peace-loving people. We will surely speak when it is spoken. And Cardinal Gracius, who is the highest authority in India for the Christians, has spoken, and he has given a statement to say that this is our position on behalf of all of us. So therefore, each of us, perhaps, we could do that every lay place to go on repeating this things and all. We did it in Bangalore because many people have been asking us, and I don't say we are slow, but we study the situation. We don't rush into this one. And we are not joining just because the majority are joining. We are also, so that people are asking us, why are we not joining? We will find that we are convinced. We will give our statement when it is necessary.
Father, you are seeing Christian institutes, many colleges, not just Christian, also come under attack because of this. How do you see this? Like, students are now, you know, going out and protesting. We've heard of incidents in Bangalore itself also. How do you react to this?
I have requested the police commissioner to give a minimum of security for our institutions on the outside. In general, we don't encourage in our institutions what we call the politics, the political part of it, because it's not our thing to educate them in politics. They are free to express outside, perhaps in their family, in their society. Surely, they have come to study, and we insist that they study properly in our institutions. And so also, we do not encourage sort of demonstrations or participants inside the institutions. I think most of the students are reacting not to this act as such inside, but to what happened in Delhi University. As being students, they feel that we are students and they are students, and they have been attacked without any provocation, and therefore perhaps we are reacting to that in some of our institutions. But we don't encourage inside. We also request the public, don't do it outside also, because let the students do their part of school. And secondly, the parents are also have to send the students to us. It's our duty to protect them, it's our duty to also see to it that they study well, that they don't get distracted with these things. At the same time, we don't curtail their freedom to have their own opinion. We will surely not influence them to this side or that side. They are grown-ups, they have their own traditions, they have their own wisdom to react in the way that they want.
While the CAA gives citizenship status to three countries, Pakistan, Bangladesh, and Afghanistan, Christians study from that. But Bhutanese Christians, they are excluded. Is there an appeal to the Prime Minister to include them also?
If you are questioning the act itself, to ask him to introduce this and that, but we, in general, we have accepted the act. Rather, we are asking for a correction of the act itself. Perhaps when that is done, we could say that accept everybody on merits, on merits. And surely if you want to be a little more kind and generous, we understand. But then don't make a distinction on the basis of religion as such.